We are with Representative Strom Peterson from the 21st District. The first thing I'd like to ask you is, what does cutoff week mean?
Cutoff just recently happened, and that means that the bills that were introduced that had policy around them, if they didn't make it out of committee, they're probably dormant, we'll say, for the rest of the year. This is the first year of the biennium, so every bill that was introduced is automatically reintroduced next year. So some of the bills that I had that didn't make it out of committee, I know I have some work to do over the interim to get those done. And that's really what this is about. And that's one of the reasons we have a biennial system, is so that these bills can get worked on. So now they're on their way to the fiscal committees, and again, getting a little wonky, but we know that there's still a lot of work to do, and we passed a lot of great bills out of all of our committees, so we're getting a lot of work done for the citizens of Washington.
Next, I want to ask you about lunch copays.
You know, this is a bill and a system that we've been working on for years. There's a handful of us legislators that have called ourselves the food fighters. And we've been working on figuring out ways to feed hungry kids. And one of our newest legislators, Representative April Berg from the 44th District, just passed the lunch copay bill off the floor of the House. And this bill, there are families that are struggling and they have to pay a 40-cent copay for each meal that their child receives. And you know, that 40 cents really adds up. And we finally realized, you know what? Those families that are struggling, especially during the pandemic, but even beyond, shouldn't have to pay that because, you know, hungry kids can't learn. And so the money that we'll invest in making sure that these kids are fed and healthy, often this is, you know, one of the only times these kids get a good meal is at school or during the pandemic, all of the school districts that have been doing great work to get meals out to the community. So a bill we've been working on. Again, Representative Berg championed this one across the finish line. It's on its way to the Senate, past the floor of the House with only one no vote.
The second thing I would like to ask you is, what is capital gains? And the reason I'm asking you is because there is a lot of confusion around this term.
Yeah, capital gains, it gets pretty confusing. And I am certainly not a financial genius by any means. But again, in broad terms, as I've said before in these chats, Washington has the most upside down tax system in the country, the most regressive tax system, meaning that the poor and the working families among us pay a much higher percentage of their income in taxes than the wealthiest. So the capital gains tax is really a tax on the sale of capital gains. If you just made a whole bunch of money on Bitcoin or GameStop, you know, good on you for doing that. But if you sell that and make a whole bunch of money, we're just asking for a small tax on the sale of that profit. And what's really great about this capital gains proposal is that the money raised there is primarily going to go to funding childcare for families all across Washington. We know that childcare is one of the primary impediments for people getting jobs that they want to get. They just can't afford good childcare. They might be eligible for a great promotion at work, but they have to put in more hours and they can't afford the childcare. So let's do what we can as a state to chip in to really strengthen our economy, make sure that working families and especially working women can get the jobs that they want, that they need, and that will really keep our economy strong. So that's one of the many reasons that I support the capital gains proposal that we have before us in the legislature this year.